Welcome back, everyone, to a stream like no other. We continue with the coda. That's right, we're writing it together. I just have to do one thing quickly. Oh, great, it's there. Oh, right, I thought that was going to take ages to add in. I just want the little sub-goal at the top there. In my dream to get 100 subs by Christmas. I changed the thing, Dynamo 8, but I just changed it now. I accidentally started the stream with yesterday's stream title. It's annoying, isn't it? Anyway, that's not interesting to talk about. Finn1991, thank you so much for the 5-month resub. And Wolfenia, thank you for subscribing. Welcome to the club. Boss, can you tell Discord that I'm coming for him in FPL? You tell him yourself, Shandy. We've got work to do. He's shaking his ghoulies. Well, that's not good. Welcome back, everyone. If you've not been here before, what is happening is, I mean, to this specific thing, we are writing a feature film. I don't know if we want to make it 90 pages long or if we want it to just be like 30 to 40 minutes, like kind of like a long short film. We can try. Tell you what, since I've been on my health kick, I'm drinking a lot of coffee. Quality over quantity. Graham. 900 pages. Should have done mini episodes. Nah. Not should have, would have. That is the worst. In hindsight. We're in it now. We could do it an hour. We could do an hour. An hour works. Because the problem with three-act structure of a film is that the way it works is the first act, let's say the first act is 20 pages, that means the second act has to be double that, that's 40, then the final act is 20 again. That's generally how, well, I mean, it's how a film like this would work, especially. There can always be coffee dehydrates you. You mind your own damn business. I've got 2 liters of water. I'm on a drip. But no, I am drinking a bit too much coffee. That is something I need to sort out. So, do we want to begin by reading? Oh yeah, I forgot you got your little chat here. Oh, and I stick this all on YouTube. Happy Saturday, Jamie Daniel Matt. Well, that's... Oh, is that close up? I mean, that's... Fine. Make myself a bit smaller there. Get the mic out of the way. The lighting is not perfect today. And then this is... Oh, okay. That should be fine. Now, so I was going to say, what we can do is read it from the beginning again. This film transcends the three-act structure. That's a good point. Do we go through and read the whole thing? Hippity-hoppity-flippity said, hello, YouTube, but the thing's gone. That was sad, to be fair. Hold on. Can that not come out a bit more? One sec, sorry. Oh, there you go. It's not quite right. Let me also just grab this sub goal and can't I get the latest sub up? Oh, I can't be bothered. Did you like the music at the start, by the way? Reread the whole thing, yeah? Just the last page says celebratory hunk. Vow that your viewers haven't storyboarded this. Don't even get me started on that, Shandy. Music was bang on, it's good, isn't it? That's by my friend Davey. He is from Dumbarton. Now, let me tell you something that I want to do, okay? In case I forget. I would like to add... So, yes, the coda is loosely based on actually a real man called Sir Brian Limmy, okay? It's a real man. An actual coder. Now, we can now begin to base things closer to his... Apparently he's a real guy, Graham. I don't know. Apparently we... Well, no, sorry. What we're going to do is we're going to base things closer to his life. So, for example, what's the area he grew up in? If anyone can remind me. I think I know it. Is it Carl No, not Millport. Carl Mordrick. How do you... Yeah, so then the coder can be like... They'll, like, no one knows anything about him. And then there can be an action scene where he's like, Carl Mordrick! That's where I'm from. And this is... This is how we do things in Carl Mordrick. You know? I also hadn't heard of that place before I read, listened to Limmy's book for free on Audible. Carl Mordrick. That could be a guy as well. Carl Wodrick. We could have a flashback to his youth, but that's something, Carl Mordrick, but that's something I would like in there today, okay? I'm new to Twitch, any advice? What do you want advice with? Would you rather face 5 overs of spin or 5 over leg spin? Off spin. I'd much rather face off spin. Leg spin is absolutely terrifying. Is this a Sports Direct mug? Advice on anything? Well, I don't know what you mean in terms of streaming or watching Twitch. Let's not talk about tennis, boss. Thank you, Silky Lemons. So. Shall we do a read-through of everything we have so far? And remember that, by the way. That's right, it's coding time. Remember, we want to add a bit in, which is like... I'll show you how we done things in Carl Mordrick. I need to look up how do you say it? Carl Mordrick? Oh, it's Carl Wardrick. He doesn't say it like that. Can I have let you play an audio of how to say it? Carl Wardrick. Is that the right place? It is, Glasgow. Dialing code is 0141. Carl Wardrick. Capital of Glasgow. I'm from a place called Carl Wardrick, capital of UK. And we don't let people talk to us like that. Carl Wardrick. London Yard is the police station. He's going to say Carl Wardrick. It's just the way he... I didn't know. It's Carl Wardrick, right? Because I've heard his audiobook. It sounds like Carl Mordrick. That's what I thought it was. I thought there was an L. Is there a way to... How do we pronounce it? Does it... Come on. Carl... I need to tell that Brian Limmy boy to enunciate better. Carl Wardrick, Glasgow City area information. Carl Roderick. As long as it starts and ends with CK, it sounds fine. Oh yeah, I know, but it's a bit like Skyfall, doesn't? Is it Skyfall where James Bond goes back to where he grew up or something? It's comforting that not even Brits can pronounce British towns. Oh, look, there's such a diversity of accents. Really, they should all talk like me, capital of UK, but they refuse to. And I'm saying that now, and so some people are going to be against, but I'm and I'm t- tell it like it is. Carl Roderick, country code 44. Just joined and now I'm very confused about what's happening. That's class. We are writing a feature film. Now, shall I begin? So, remember, something I would like today. So, we're going to add another 2 pages. We've got 20 pages? Now, we've got about, we're on page 18, so about 17 pages. Have I put all of this? Where did it end last time? Okay. We're going to go from the top, everyone. He should go back to his hometown, but it's Ben Nevis. Well, it's going to be that scene, the Carnodric scene, is going to be set in London, obviously. Limmy's on the Wikipedia page. Hold on. Who else is a notable resident? Is there anyone else? That's funny, man. Notable residents. Brian Limmy Limmond, comedian, grew up in Carnodric. Attended Carnodric Primary School. And Bobby Wellens, a saxophonist. He could go back to his hometown and be like, Bobby, long time no see. He goes to the jazz club, the Carnodric Jazz Club, because he needs his help. Bobby, long time no see. And he's like, is that you, Brian? Damn it, I thought you were dead. You know what they say, Bobby? What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And I've been in some gunfights. Oh, I've been in some gunfights. Oh. And he can have, like, his saxophone, obviously, can shoot bullets, you know? Big Bobby the Sax Man. I'm going to tweet him and say, do you know Bobby Wellens? I'm going to say, do you know Bobby Wellens personally? It's for a thing. It's for a thing. Please reply ASAP. Quick. No, just please reply ASAP. Okay? Careless Whisper playing in the back. Oh, I forgot about how fun these Coda streams are. Didn't shower today. Okay. It's gonna be like Bobby. What's his name? Bobby Wellens. Brian, is that you? Bobby can override all mainframes by playing notes. Bobby sadly died, so can't reprise a cameo. Did he die? Oh, that's sad. Is he really old? Bobby Wellens. Oh, he died aged 80. Okay, so for respect, we'll change his name. Call him Bobby Wellies. No, that's wrong. Dedicated to Bobby. Look, let's not be... Look. Ellis Things, thank you very much for the 8-month streak. Good evening, Mr. Safkex. Here is money. Thank you. He hasn't got back to me yet. Shall I give him a call? Wouldn't that be really funny if I called his phone? Like, I wouldn't do it Saturday evening, but it would be really funny. I was like, hi, do you know what... Bobby Sachs. Died at 80, to be fair. Yeah. It would have been better if he was alive, because I genuinely would have tweeted him. Do you know Bobby Wellens personally? It's for a thing. No reply. And the way he goes on. You know? Oh, I'm not playing any games with anyone anymore. And that sort of thing. And then I'm asking about Bobby Wellens because I'm writing a script about your life. Okay, everyone. We're going to read from the top. Get us back in the habit. But I feel like we've already got... I feel like we've got the next two pages, man. Phone him and ask him how you pronounce it. Yep, that's right. I've got one of the two notable... I've got one of the two numbers of the notable residents. One of the two notable residents numbers. That's hard to say. Why is he going home? We'll get to that. So basically, he's on the run. They're on the run, right? And it's like, but Brian, where can we go? That's a dingo. The one place no one will look because they don't know about it. Home. Because no one knows where he's from. Carl Mordrick, capital of UK. The jazz club, Brian. Is this another secret coding lab? Nah, I just like jazz. Okay, right. Okay, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Writing the Coder. I don't know which session we are on now. We are about something like 17 pages in. I'm going to go through this very quickly, but it would be nice to read through it and refresh our memories. This is something we were doing weekly before, and then I sort of just changed it to whenever. Here we go. From the top, but I'm going to go quite quick, okay? It's another great opportunity for A White Man Explains Jazz. Exactly. It's going to be great. Has he not replied yet? This guy, honestly, this guy's unbelievable. I need to know how to pronounce the name of his home. And also, yeah, so. The Coder by Zaffy Cakes and the chat. Please let me know, or if Lemmy replies to my tweet, could you just, while I'm reading this, could you reply to him and say thanks? Say thanks, big man. If everyone could reply when he replies, if he replies to me, if everyone could reply to him and say thanks, big man. Anyway, Coder by Zaffy Cakes and the chat. Interior, living room, day. Hold on. Shall I have some music on? I'll do it after the reading. I'll get some music on. Interior, living room, day. The Coder wears a navy dressing gown, sits in his large apartment living room with giant windows overlooking London, reading a magazine about codes. What a load of Java. Sips coffee from a giant Sports Direct mug. Now that's the Java, like, damn it, that's what I'm bloody talking about. Quality. The Coder then looks around the room and you hear a crunch. Ah, I love chips. We see that he is talking about microchips and the crunch came from eating a microchip. He burps. The phone suddenly rings. The ringtone is Hyperlink by Eiffel 65. What a song. What a beautiful day it is in London. Capital of UK. He sighs and begrudgingly answers his phone, a flip Motorola. Talk, nah, pronto. Coder, get out of there. What, I'm having me morning Java and reading me coding mag, you muppet. There's no time. What, who is this? What's the script? The Java script. Oh, sorry, I have to exit WhatsApp. The Coder then looks at his phone to see the number and notices some movement in its reflection. He drops to the floor and bullets shatter his giant window overlooking London. The glass falls onto London in slow motion. Only 9 a.m. and Windows has already crashed. He rolls over the living room sideways, then does a forward roll to his Wi-Fi router and pulls out a pistol, rolls backwards to the printer, pulls out some bullets and loads the gun. The Coder fires back. Just a bit of troubleshooting. Better take me tablet. The Coder grabs a Windows tablet. We see a Bing search for circuit boards. He locks the tablet so that the screen goes off and we see three men lurking with body armor masked with machine guns in the reflection. He does another sideways roll, unlocks the tablet, and opens an app. Presses the screen, and his television, radio, Xbox, microwave, kettle, shower, and toaster all turn on. The three masked men panic and begin to shoot the toaster. Should have got that blooming warranty sorted. The coder then shoots at the men, taking out two of them. The final masked man does a big leap out of the smashed window. The coder manages to grab and rip off part of the masked man's clothing before the jump. Not staying for a cup of tea. The coder looks out the window and sees the masked man parachuting down onto London. The coder looks at the torn material in his hand and it says Omniflux Incorporated. Time to code. Opening titles. Which, well, I won't play them now. Interior warehouse evening. A giant secret warehouse full of codes scrolling vertically down large screen wires, keyboards, servers, circuit boards and other computer components. Dingo, a very posh, bumbling British coding scientist, is building a house of cards out of floppy disks. Okay, old boy, that should do it. A door slams and the house of floppy disks collapses. Not again, Brian. Must you enter like a bull in a china shop every time? The coder, wearing a tracksuit with fingerless gloves, storms into the warehouse. This bull's just seen red. Don't tell me. Caught hacking. Again. Not quite. That's about I nearly got shut down. What? Are you okay? Yeah, but me toaster's brown bread. Dead. Interior warehouse kitchen evening. The coder and Dingo sit at a small table eating buttered toast and drinking coffee. The television is on in the background. Omniflux, the tech giants. That can't be so. Tell it to me, Windows. And you say you received a call of warning? From whom? They didn't leave an email address. They didn't leave an email address. They used a VPN. A virtual private network? So you can't trace the call. Bingo Dingo. Can you run a full diagnostic check on the Omniflux, lads? Already have. Dingo shows his black laptop screen and green text says coding check positive. What? The coding check is positive? It all checks out. I don't think these are your lads, Brian. Who made the call? Who wants me deleted? Who made the call? Who wants me saved? Who wants me deleted? The television suddenly cuts to breaking news. Oi, turn that up! We interrupt this broadcast to bring you some breaking news. A photo of the coder is on screen. This man is wanted for crimes of hacking into the government and our royal family's Outlook accounts to commit a terror attack on London, UK. The coder and Dingo look at each other shocked. Dingo drops his toast. Looks like I've just gone viral. Interior, the coder's apartment, day. Police and forensic officers are in the apartment. Crime scene, yellow tape everywhere, sorry. Detective Chief Inspector Craig Donald, 60 years old, smart, moustached, looks around bemused, shaking his head. Detective Inspector Samantha Kennedy arrives at the scene. The random policeman. Sorry, this is a crime scene, sweetheart. There's been a crime here, I'm afraid. A murder? Not at liberty to say, madam. Could be terror-related, though. D.I. Kennedy holds up her police badge. Well, it will be a murder in a minute if you don't shift yourself, bozo. The random police officer looks absolutely mortified, like he's about to cry. Sorry, Mom. I'll get the coffees in. Yeah, you do that. Sweetheart. Samantha, it seems like they're all falling into crab these days. But boss, not the coder. I've seen this many times. You can't trust anyone. What are you saying, boss? This code's been corrupted. D.I. Kennedy stares at D.I. Donald in disbelief. She begins to march around the apartment, desperately searching for some evidence. She looks at a bowl of microchips and a coding magazine. Who knows what his game is? Probably a big paycheck. But a terror attack on Her Majesty? Seems a bit out of order, don't you think? D.I. Kennedy then notices that the Sports Direct mug still has coffee in it. She looks confused. She then turns to look at the toaster. It's missing. No, something's not right here, boss. He would never abandon Java. D.I. Kennedy looks out of the window onto London, steps back and realises that one of the large windows panels is different to the others. It's double glazed. Brian hated double glazing. He said it was one more layer between him and the city he loves. London, capital of UK, you should say.
Flippin' heck, Samantha, you might be onto something. He would never update windows.
Internet cafe evening. Coda and Dingo enter an old, worn-out looking internet cafe called Megabytes Internet Cafe and Printing Sons in the City of London, UK. The Coda is disguised in a fake moustache, long-haired wig and a bowler hat and a three-piece suit. Dingo is wearing exactly the same disguise. Brian, are you sure this is the place?
Dingo, you're the smartest code scientist and analyst in town. And you can't see this? You absolute muppet.
Coda laughs, Dingo looks at the building, and then at Coda, confused, as they enter. They go up to the front desk, where Paperclip, a nerdy-looking man, wearing a Windows 95 t-shirt, is reading a comic book, looking bored. Hello? The man ignores them.
Vista!
The man drops his comic and looks up, shocked. He lowers his sunglasses. Excuse me?
Hold it together, Paperclip!
Right, yeah. Nice one. Sick, of course, bruv. Paperclip lifts his mouse pad up and presses a secret button on the table. A desk with a computer on suddenly moves to the side like a sliding door. Dingo is shocked. Coda laughs.
Nice one, bruv.
Bruv?
Get with the lingo, Dingo.
Behind the sliding doors is a lift. Coda and Dingo get in. Paperclip then looks outside, making sure no one is watching, and presses a button to make the room go back to normal. He goes back to reading his comic. He looks at his screen where he's just done a Bing search for bowler hats. Little comedy bit. Interior, secret coding lair, evening. Coda and Dingo walk into a giant cave-like dungeon. It's very dark with codes, it should say, zeros and ones, projected all around the cave walls in green. Dingo looks terrified and then realizes something. Wait. I know what this is. You mentioned this before. This is where your mentor works.
You finally switched on, Dingo.
Where is he? He? Haha. Motherboard emerges from the shadows wearing a black cloak. Dingo, I've heard so much about you. Heard you can hack a mainframe in 6 seconds. 5 seconds as of yesterday morning, m'lady. Motherboard smiles and Dingo blushes.
What are we going to do with you, Brian? I'm hacked off. I never done nothing. And I love my country. UK.
You think I don't know that? Didn't you recognize my voice?
You made the call. You auto-saved me.
Look, there's no time. They're coming for you. And Her Majesty of UK.
Who?
Suddenly, the green-lit code turns red and masked men storm the lair with machine guns.
Damn it, get down!
Bullets fire into Motherboard.
No!
She glitches as they hit her and she makes a window shutdown sound as she screams. She is a hologram. She disappears.
No, we had a connection!
Coda grabs Dingo and shoves him under a table.
Don't lose your dongle, Dingo! Plenty more fish in the sea. Drive.
Coda gets under the table with Dingo and loads his mini machine gun. Gunshots suddenly echo from the other direction.
It's a double-sided attack. Don't be so sure. I recognise that shooter noise. A sawed-off shotgun.
They see Paperclip do a flip, then a forward roll and join them under the table. They nod to each other.
Time to empty the recycling bin.
Let's do this ting, bruv. They do a synchronized sideways roll and begin to fire back. Dingo hides under the table, trembling. What's the matter, Dingo, mate? Never shot a shooter, bruv. Why make all that noise when the best way to offload is code? Dingo has opened his mini laptop and is typing code very fast.
You shift left, I'll shift right.
What about him? Looking at Dingo.
He's gone incognito. Paperclip does a front flip and shoots at two men, taking them out. Coda sprints forward, jumps toward a cave wall, rebounds off the wall, and does a flying kick at one of the men. Coda then appears behind two of the men and smashes their heads together as he screams. So, ah! Heads up, crashed your interface. While you're buffering, we've got more company. Don't get lippy, Clippy. About 50 more masked men march in. Looks like we're gonna need tech support. Quick time, Dingo! 5.2 more seconds. Dingo continues to furiously type zeros and ones into his small laptop. Coda does a run-up and throws a diving punch into one of the men. A masked man is suddenly behind Coda and is about to shoot him. Dingo presses enter on his laptop. That should do it. Sprinklers turn on, and a man pointing a gun has his mask fogged up. Paperclip throws a floppy disk into the man's neck. Nice work, Dingo. He won't eject that disk. Good save, Clippy. Coda and Paperclip nod to each other and roll back under the table. The masked men have finally removed their masks. They all look exactly the same, like clones. Bloody hell. They've only gone and copied and pasted. I've located the back door to escape. Dingo has a map of the building up on his screen. But how do we get there, bruv? Coda looks around as he is in deep thought. As about a firewall. Coda points his gun at a barrel of oil and shoots it, causing oil to spill out. He then grabs a very long HDMI cable and lassos the barrel so that it rolls across the floor in front of the approaching men. He then pulls a USB stick out of Dingo's laptop. You didn't eject it safely. I know. Excuse me. He throws it onto the oil, igniting a large flame, a literal firewall. That's what I call a hotfix. Access denied. Dingo and Paperclip rush towards the exit. Coda looks through the flames and sees his clones' faces melting and then joins the other two. Interior classroom day. Motherboard is teaching a class about coding. And with a C++, you can do anything. Not that any of you will be getting a C++. The class laughs. Coda is smartly dressed, making notes. Samantha Kennedy smiles and hands him a note. He begins to open it when the fire alarm goes off. Coda looks around, panicked. No one else seems to hear it. It stops. Coda looks behind him to see Dingo accidentally drop all of his books from his desk, and everyone laughs. Coda tried to speak, and he tries to speak, and no sound comes out of his mouth. He looks confused. He opens the note and sees a drawing of the Queen. He looks up at Motherboard and sees that she has turned into the Queen. He pulls out a gun and points it at her. Everyone in the classroom has turned into the Coda. They turn and smile at him. The alarm goes off again, and now we can also faintly hear a modem dial-up sound. Coda smiles and is about to pull the trigger. Interior car day. Coda, so it's a dream, you see. Coda, laying down on the back seat of a minivan, suddenly wakes up from his nightmare. No! He looks forward to see the driver and notices it's Samantha. He then rubs his eyes and realizes it's actually Paperclip. Dingo sits next to him, typing away on his laptop. Everything all right, bruv? Sorry, I was just in sleep mode. Sick one, you needed a reboot. I'm feeling refreshed. Time to update drivers. Coda jumps into the driving seat and Paperclip jumps to the side. Coda accelerates towards a red light. Dingo presses enter on his laptop and the light turns green. Interior, London Yard, UK day. Samantha Kennedy and Greg Donald sit in a conference office in London Yard listening to Douglas Bollard give a briefing about the case. And as you can see here, this man intends to kill our majesty and we shan't be letting that happen. Samantha and Craig look at each other confused. So get out there and catch this traitor before our majesty... Oh, so get out there and catch this traitor because our majesty is very important to me. Everyone leaves the room except Samantha. Douglas, just wanted to say congratulations on leading your first investigation. It's a big one. Well, always the biggest and best for Douglas Bollard. He picks up his files and quickly tries to leave the room. Samantha steps in front of him. It's just, did you get my facts about the apartment looking like it had just been totally renovated and the toaster? Come on now, Samantha. We mustn't waste our time and let this madman slay our majesty. But now, please, only fax me when you've got something important. They're interrupted when they notice a crowd gathering around a television in the office. They rush to see what's happening. On TV, Interior News Studio Day. Oh, sorry, I didn't need to read. A news presenter is reporting on some breaking news. We now go live to the Omniflux press conference with the president of Omniflux, Sebastian Kingston. Yes, well, very troubling goings on in London, the capital of UK. I'll keep it brief. Anyone that can catch this wicked man, dead or indeed alive, will receive a £1 million GBP British pound Omniflux gift card reward. Thank you. Interior London office, eh? What? He can't say that. Well, he just did. You're going to allow vigilante murder in London, UK? Samantha, grow up. We need all the help we can get. You'll understand when you get to lead your own investigation. Douglas storms off. Samantha turns to Craig, speechless. It is what it is, Samantha. Only you've been... Once you've been in the job as long as I have, you gotta just excuse... You gotta just execute the task you're given. Samantha sighs and shakes her head. Interior, Dingo's apartment, evening. Coda, Dingo, and Paperclip are playing a three-way game of checkers. Excuse me. So you say he took his mask off and looked a bit like you? Damn it, Dingo, he was me. A CC carbon copy, handsome son of a... What, bruv? You reckon it was a clone, like? Couldn't have been too handsome then. Coda grabs Paperclip by the nose. Careful, Paperclip. Sorry. Sorry, I forgot about this. Careful, Paperclip. I'll straighten you out. Only kidding. He was well fit, mate. Sorry, I forgot about that line. He was well fit, mate. Take it easy, Brian. Sorry, Clippy. It's all crashing in on me. No worries, bruv. No problem can't be debugged. They continue to play checkers. Feel like I might be lagging behind. Paperclip takes one of Coda's pieces in checkers. As long as you're ahead of your opponent, mate. Coda moves a piece to take all three of Paperclip's pieces. We need to be three steps ahead of our opponent, and we need to make sure our majesty is safe. Speaking of which, king me. Samantha Kennedy is looking through the evidence, shaking her head. It just doesn't add up. Samantha storms across the building and goes into Douglas Bollard's office. She notices that he is in a meeting. Bollard looks red-faced. Sorry. Oh, I'm so sorry. Didn't they teach you to knock at London University? No problem. I was just leaving. Samantha looks shocked. Kingston puts his hand out for her to shake. Kingston, and you are... A nervous-looking Bollard interrupts. This is Detective Inspector Samantha Kennedy. Miss Kennedy, coding extraordinaire. How did you... Well, I've read your paper on the ethics of coding. Fascinating stuff. Oh, thank you. Well, I don't really do that anymore. Oh, well, you simply must stop by at our office sometime. If you ever get bored of playing cops and robbers, we'd love to work with a brilliant young mind such as yourself. Kingston hands Samantha his card and gives her a big smile. He's a baddie. And ladies and gentlemen, that is what we have thus far. We're up to page 18. Well done, everyone. This script is written with your help, of course. That's not quite right, is it? I should be smaller. Hello? There you go. Sorry about that. There we go. And now you can see yourself on screen. Well done, everyone. Well done. Well done, everyone. Wonderful stuff. Tarky Fensington, thank you so much for gifting a sub to Davy Boy 4. And Davy Boy 4, thank you for gifting a sub to the Holy Goose Oli.
Has Limmy replied to my tweet yet? It's very important for the scripts. Has this guy replied? No reply. Wow. I said, do you know Bobby Wellens personally? It's for a thing. Please reply ASAP. Well, Bobby's going in the script then. Well done, everyone. Well done. Reckon he's asleep. He's probably watching, like, Bake Off. You know, unbelievable. Imagine if I didn't reply to him. You know when he comes in and is like, hello. And if I don't reply immediately, he's absolutely raging about it. Evening. Promise no effing and jeffing. Yeah, please, Craig. All right. No effing and jeffing this time. So we have a lot of things happening. We have Craig Russell-Horn. We're gonna do some of the Coda's backstory in Carl Mordrick. Eight months, woohoo. Did you just subscribe? Did I miss it? Dad's Army is on BBC Two. That's probably what he's watching. Blathwaite, thank you for the 8 month resub. Oh, it just popped up now. Thank you very much. Yeah, it's a bit weird. So, let's look at quickly. Sub goal not on this screen? Is it not? For God's sake, this is the main screen. Unreal. Wait. Oh, it's there. Thank you for the reminder. Looks lovely. Have you noticed that a little boy called Joey Page has the same font sub goal? Why do you think that is? I was like, how did he get my font? That's right, I gave him my old PC. And he kept that little OBS setting. Only me and Joey Page have it. Metal Gear Solid soundtrack on this in the background, please. Tarky, we are going to put some stream beats on. I forgot that we have music in this. It's been so long. Stream beats, but we need some chill out music, but not that Japanese style thing, not that one that he did, the other one. Let me just pick an album. Where are your flipping albums? Stream beats. Okay. I don't want to, like, because I don't want to have to worry about skipping songs and, you know what I mean? Albums. No. Stream beats. Stream beats, see all. Sorry about the odd mouse on screen, must look a bit annoying. Lo-fi, sugar stream beats. Are these free though? I don't want it to get like muted and all of that nonsense, you know? I should look for Harris Heller, shouldn't I? I feel like we have, sorry, I'll get into it in a sec. It's so cool that he makes loads of money off of this. Like, it's so clever. Sorry, everyone. I'm just trying to find... Because a lot of his albums have a different sound, but we want, like, a chilled out one. Not, like, an up... Not too upbeat, you know? It would be off-putting. How does this sound? Gold. That's a new album. That works. Test, test, test. Oh, you can't hear it. Test, test. Meteor Binge. Was he running my sub numbers? I don't think that's possible. Okay, test, test. I'll turn it right down. That's all right, yeah? Okay, so. Soundtrack to the beach. That's the classic playlist, Taki. I'm not going to play any copyrighted stuff because it will get muted. And I want people to be able to watch the old VOD. This is... Thank you, Taki. This is what we normally listen to. So, let's look at where we are. Okay? Let's look at where we are. In fact, let's look at this first. If you want to see the actors that are going to play each role, I'll go through that quickly. The Coda is, of course, Jason Statham. Dingo is Benedict Cumberbatch. Newsreader is... yep. Can you see this? Random Policeman is Martin Clunes, of course. DCI Craig Donald is Sean Bean. Samantha Kennedy is Phoebe Waller-Bridge. Paperclip is Stephen Merchant. Motherboard is Madonna. The Masked Men are, of course, also Jason Statham. The Queen is Meghan Markle. Douglas Bollard is Colin Firth. And Sebastian Kingston is Richard E. Grant, as if that wasn't already obvious. This is our classic music. So, sorry, I'm just going to pop the music down a bit for myself. It's a bit loud in my ear, as they say. That's much better. Okay, so Coda is potentially being framed for planning a terror attack on Her Majesty. Okay, him and Paperclip are on the run. Sorry, him and Dingo are on the run, and Paperclip is with them now. Samantha Kennedy and Craig Donald are investigating. Douglas Bollard is leading the case. Now, there's something a bit dodgy about that as well. Hey, podcast merch. Douglas Bollard is leading the case, which is a bit fishy. And he was, remember, she walked in on him speaking to the president of Omniflux. They were just having a casual meeting, right? Now, Samantha has been invited to visit the Omniflux headquarters. She doesn't know yet that he's basically behind it all. I think it might be nice if that character... I think it might be nice if Sebastian Kingston wants to take Samantha on a date. And he tries to be romantic about it. It's not the only thing he was doing. We can't get into that now. You also thought that, Tarky. It's what would happen, isn't it? Bollard as Richard E. Grant clone, maybe? So I thought... So they're in cahoots with each other, right? And that's why when Samantha's like putting all this evidence forward and he's ignoring it, it's because he's up to no good, right? He will get killed, don't worry about that. We don't want Jodie Foster. We want Phoebe Waller-Bridge is really the thing, the talk of the town right now. Haim 67. When he says brilliant young mind, make a weird body comment as well. Brilliant young mind. And not too, what do you say? Not too what on the eyes? And a nice face too. And not too shabby in the appearance. Not too hard on the eyes. Evening, boss. Which act are we on? We're still in the first act, but we're coming to the end. But we have so many overlapping storylines now, which is great, by the way. Okay, so there's that. That's everything there. Now, they're driving somewhere, right? They are Coda, Paperclip, and Coda, Dingo, and Paperclip are driving somewhere. Are we going? Are we going back to the Coda's home, which is Car Mordric? How do you say it again? Car Mordric. Road trip to Car Mordric. So that's how I thought. Car Mordric, new character. Ten-hour van trip. They're not driving a Peugeot 206, Craig. They're in a van, like a little minibus type thing. Wait, why would they be in a Peugeot? Carn Wardrick. Well, it doesn't matter because he's gonna be like. So, do we want that scene now, and then the scene after can be Samantha Kennedy and Omniflux? Oh, you know what's gonna happen? Coda's gotta tell Samantha like. It's Omniflux, and then she's like, of course. And then her and Richard E. Grant have got to go on a date, basically. And she's got to try and get some evidence. And he's like a wonderful mind and quite the appearance. A charming female such as yourself. What do you say, Samantha? A dame such as yourself ever find herself with an old rascal such as I? What do you say? For old time's sakes? Sorry to be awfully devilish, but would a kitten such as yourself ever find herself with an old raccoon such as I?
That's not a bad idea, Fire Girl. Lots of bumbling around. Exactly.
That bit can be really... That bit, he can just like keep repeating the same thing. Like I just did. Keeps repeating it in like different ways. 10 minutes of that. Thank you, Fire Girl. Okay. So, shall we go back to Carl Mordrick now?
He has an earpiece in and is getting fed chat-up lines. Yeah, by an AI.
There can be like a robot waiter. It looks like something from Robot Wars. And then he's like, she's like, how about some more? The dessert is eaten mess, obviously. She's like, how about some more eaten mess? And he goes, right away, anything for you. And he sneaks off, and then she's got to hack into the thing and like do the coding thing, code check, and then she finds the evidence that, oh, you know, or she sees his phone, and it's like takeout, it's like motherboard won't be a problem anymore, you know, something. Oh, this is great, eat and mess. Did you mean the dessert or you mean me? Heston Blumenthal. Oh, is he gonna say that? Or I thought it was you calling yourself an eaten mess. Well, if you fancy any more eaten mess, you're looking right at him. I'll be back in a jiffy, my dear.
He keeps trying to kiss her ass.
He goes... Any more eaten mess? You're looking right at it, my lovely.
We like this song. The great thing is we already have so much. See, this is the thing, everyone. I know some people weren't happy that I stopped the coda for a while, but genuinely though, like with a lot of stuff like this, if you leave something and come back to it, you do sometimes come back kind of full of ideas. Like,
tuck in, my beautiful maiden. Tell me, are there angels as sweet as you in heaven?
You know, it's just like, it's just really like...
Oh god,
it's time to code. Yeah, you gotta write this, Don, like you do with the diss tracks. Can't let this gold slip away. Yeah, that's a good point. I feel like we've got it all. So excuse me, I think what we do is, in fact, because that'll be class next week if we come back, because the thing is, he said come and see me sometime, right? Basically, she's going to go see him and she doesn't know it's a date. Like, she's gone into the office just to be like, to try and see what's going on. But then he's got like a 3-course meal prepared and like, you know, I'll be the sponge if you'll be my Victoria. Would you mind awfully if I go to the bathroom?
Would you mind awfully if I'm excused to the toilet of the bathroom? I'm afraid I have a terrible tummy ache. You see, it is not just my heart that you've made hurt.
I have an awful tummy ache.
Okay, so that's not going to happen now, though, okay? That can be next week, and then that way we have something to look forward to. I'm really happy with this, everyone. I felt like it was kind of losing, like, steam and, like, where do we actually go, apart from it all ending in, like, violence. But actually, it can just... There's so much that can happen. Speaking of eating worse, it's back in a big way, I agree. Did she have a chapter on AI love robots and her ethics? Yeah, there should be a whole thing about ethics.
Now, you say ethically we shouldn't be using AI in the battlefield. But think about this, Samantha. If there are some awful terrorists and the AI can wipe out the entire country, then are we not in agreement that it is in fact ethically superior, you know?
57, everyone, thank you very much. Yes, so what's happened is the watch is running out of battery and now it beeps at 56, unfortunately. 20 mins of that. Maybe I should get someone on to act out a few scenes. That's not a bad idea, is it? We should incorporate 57 into the script. Yeah, we should. That's a good idea. Wait, has Timmy replied yet? Do you know Bobby Wellens personally? Yeah, no reply. I don't. Has he passed to spirit? He has, sadly, but the coda is going back to Carn Wardrick in our script, and he's gonna meet Bobby in the jazz club. So he did reply. Get a script consultant on after the first act. Every time it shows a clock, it can be at 57 minutes. That's a good, yeah, that's something. Thank you, Firegal, for tweeting him as well, because he's obviously got me blocked on there. Okay, so shall we say now, is everyone happy that we are driving back to Carn Wardrick? Carn Wardrick, right? Now, maybe he's going to go back to his family home with, like, his granddad. Thanks, big man. Yeah. So I asked you to reply to the tweet with thanks, big man, if he replied. And loads of people, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people have replied, thanks, big man, to living. It's really good. Can he immediately have a Scottish accent? Well, this is the thing, Beverly Hills Cop 2. In this script, because it's for Hollywood, Carn Wardrick is, yeah, maybe it's London. We don't really know. Do you know what I mean? It's like, basically, like a lot of films, it's like a farmy area. Which I know that's not what it's like in real life, but it's like farms, and it's where he grew up. Now, he's going to go into his bedroom, and he's got, like, a car bed and stuff, and he can, like, I've got all me old coding gear, completely untraceable. Yes, I've got it. Because, yeah, he's got an Amiga. Because the purpose of him going here is because it's the only secure way he can contact Samantha, because he needs to tell her. Do you remember what the dream... This is actually, like, decent. Do you remember the dream showed us that him and Samantha went to school together? And he had that little moment where he thought she was driving the car, then he rubs his eyes. Right? I should tell you the ridiculous thing. I've been trying to write an actual script. I mean, actual... a script apart from this by myself for like a couple of months, and I found it really hard. And we're absolutely killing this. Only place in the UK with no GPS coverage, can't be traced. Exactly, Hot Reef. Now you're getting it. Now you're getting it. So, the amount of people that have replied, "Thanks, big man," is really funny. So I think 11 people have replied, "Thanks, big man." Just looks really funny. So, Limmy, this is what's going to happen, right? Khan Wardrick, which I didn't know. Bellini Travel. Okay, don't go anywhere. Stay there for now. Right, don't run off. What's happening is, right, he's got to go where he's going to go back to his old bedroom. Khan Wardrick. It's completely untraceable, right? To contact his friend in the police, right? He's going to go to the jazz club. Khan Wardrick. Bobby! Long time no see. Brian, I thought you was dead. You know what I say, Bobby? What they hear you make you stronger. Khan Wardrick. So, the way you say that, I didn't know. So, I googled like Khal Modric, because I thought that's what it was. Lo and behold, you've been doing it wrong. Like Wad, Khan Wardrick. And also, I should say, right, I hope you don't take offense, but because this is essentially a Hollywood script, I was saying before that maybe it's Khan Wardrick. Like, is it in London? We don't know. Khan Wardrick, capital of UK, where it all started. Got me first coding. iPad. Make it in London. Scotland is a career ender. It's actually not. You know why you're wrong? You know why you're incredibly wrong? Skyfall, the Bond film, he goes back to like where he grew up or whatever. It's in Scotland. Is that the right film? See? Okay. Okay, so they're driving somewhere. Where on earth are we, Brian? Home. Khan Wardrick. Khan Wardrick. Capital of UK, where it all started. Let me just check. Are we ready to continue? What time is it? So ideally, I'd like to have these two pages done by 10. And then, I don't know, maybe we can play The Witcher again. Do people like that? I love it. Make his hometown in Scotland. In the Scotland playground instead of the yard. What do you mean? Always used as a back to my roots thing. Never a current place. Exactly. Exactly. Like use electricity. Yeah. The people do normal things like use electricity. Yeah. That's what we're doing. It is for Hollywood, okay? You know? Look. Your culture aside, all of that, we have to just... This is the meeting we'd have if we went to Hollywood. They'd be like, look, you have to put that all to one side. Scotland. They'll be like, oh, Scotland, like, you know, Mrs. Doubtfire, Mike Myers' various creations. And we would have to... And then Limmy would be, like, about to get angry, tensing... And I'd have to nudge him and be like, come on, man, we're about to get this. Shrek. And I go, yeah, like Shrek. Like, shut up. We're this close. So. Okay. Scotland, is that in England? Yeah, exactly. excuse me. Kingston Hand, Samantha. Okay. So what we're doing is never Glasgow, always some hills. Yeah, yeah, exactly. So in my mind, Carl Mordrick. I actually don't know the best way to say it. There's no like pronunciation thing. When I heard like your book, it sounded like Carl Mordrick. Carl Mordrick is what I heard. So I googled that and it's like, no, Carn Wodrick was a farm. Oh, it was a farm owned by Sir John Maxwell. I was going to make it a farm. Oh, we love this song. You're saying it right, Carn Wodrick. We love this song. Wait till it drops. This is Stream Beats, everyone. We're about to get to the writing. It's coming. Just sounds a bit like you're saying Wardrick. It's our favourite song. It's our favourite free song. Okay, anyway, back to work. Great, innit? Go out speaking the kings. It's a good steel drum, to be fair. They are real steel drums. I'm representing for coders all across the world. Yeah. Oh, man, there's so much we can do with this. So let me tell you, everyone, what's happening is, at this point, the coder's going to go back to his hometown. He's going to contact... And we've got it. We've got the next, like, bit sorted now. He's going to contact his old friend Samantha Kennedy, because she's in the police, right? In a special coding way that only they can do. Then after that Samantha Kennedy goes on a date with the guy, like, you know, tries to investigate him, and that's when he's like, what was he saying again? What do you say, Samantha? Could a beautiful angel such as yourself ever be with a old badger such as I? You know, that kind of thing. Has to be a scene like in Hackers. I don't think I've seen it. No technology, so he has to train a message pigeon. No, I think there has to be technology. Get Samantha Janus in this. Bring her back like Tarantino brought back Travolta. I need to check who that is again. I'm sorry. Samantha Janus. Oh! From EastEnders. I wasn't expecting. Alright, I'll speak to her. Send an email. Okay. Alright, so. I was really hoping you were friends with that Bobby guy. Or him from Heartbeat. Let me, because you're here, I'll give you the rundown of the cast quickly. I don't know if you know. The coder is Jason Statham. Dingo is Benedict Cumberbatch. The newsreader is me. Random policeman is Martin Clunes. Craig Donnelly is Sean Bean. Samantha Kennedy is Phoebe Waller-Bridge. Paperclip is Stephen Merchant. Motherboard is Madonna. The Masked Man are, of course, Jason Statham. The Queen is Meghan Markle. Douglas Bollard is Colin Firth. And Sebastian Kingston is Richard E. Grant. That is who we have thus far. Now, interior van. Was it a van they were driving? Sorry. Was it like a minibus? Wait, his apartment. Oh, okay. We've got a little... it works. It's fine. We can sort this out after. Minivan? Good cast. I know. Minivan. Is that what it was? Minivan. Let's say... Need a comedy actor. Who would be the comic relief? We could get Jamie Kennedy. To be like some kind of Scottish farmer. He can do the accent and everything. Is minivan, evening? Here in London, UK, we don't say minivan. Yeah, but this script is for Americans. Bear that in mind. James Corden. James Corden could be a clown, and there could be a bit where they stop in a service station. And I don't know, he could like run out of a toilet. So there's a coach. You know when coaches stop at, if you've ever, they stop at service stations. And the coach is leaving without him. And he goes, no, no, wait for me. And he's like fully dressed as a clown, and he's got toilet paper coming off his shoe there. That's the kind of comedy we need in this film. For Americans with Martin Clunes attached. He's making a comeback. I like how annoyed people are. Wonder if we can get a cameo by Nicholas Lyndhurst, make him a baddie, flip it all. So the baddie at the moment is Richard E. Grant. In fact, you did that because you put him in your song. Is Russ Abbott still alive? He could play a serious Scotsman to apologise. Simon Pegg is already in it. No, wait, he's not in it. No, instead of Simon Pegg, we cast Stephen Merchant, didn't we? Yeah, Stephen Merchant is Paperclip. James Corden is driving the van. The entire scene is shot through the windscreen. Carpool karaoke, oh god. Okay, interior minivan evening. We've got a bit of a problem here because this... We're going to have to go back and edit something, but we'll do that after... I mean, how many pages do we have? Almost 20? Maybe next week... We do have to go through and script edit at some point. Sort out the little mistakes. Just for the record, the Corden suggestion was ironic. Can't think of many people I hate less. Max Nicholson, it's... You think any of this isn't ironic? Maybe a serious CU Jimmy like Ledger's Joker compared to Nicholson's. Oh, I like this song as well. Interesting. Get Simon Pegg playing a character called Scotty. Ah, this is quite nice, this music. A gritty See You Jimmy. Wait, I don't know what See You Jimmy is. Maybe a serious See You Jimmy. See You Jimmy is the ginger hat thing. Oh. What? Wait. Russ Abbott's Scottish character. Oh, I have to Google. I'm sorry, I don't know about these things. Oh, right. Oh, I like this music, though. It's quite nice. I did look it up, yeah. Very nice. So... Coda is speeding around the countryside. So basically, Dingo. There's got to be a twist, right? Paperclip's got to be bad in it somehow. That's good, Hot Reef. That's very good, Hot Reef. Hold on. Coda is speeding around the countryside with Dingo and Paperclip. Whoops. Yeah, Paperclip. Dingo says, there's absolutely... no signal. Where the hell can we be? Okay. Welcome to Con Wardrick, birthplace of Brian the Coda Limit, yeah. Too much like that awful David Schwimmer ad lately. I don't know what that is. Some pun about being off the grid coming up. Oh, we'll get to that. Coda. Home. Where can we be? We're home. Home. And then it's like, paperclip is like, You what, bruv? And then Coda's like, because he's never taught, no one knows where he's from, innit? Sorry, the camera is shaking because I knocked my desk. We're going back to where it all began, back to the source code. The only phones that work around here are saxophones. Oh, that's good. Hot Reef is on it today. I love how into this scene you are. Right. Wait. Back where it all began. My home. Where I was born. How do you spell it again? Carn Wardrick. Is that right? With a C. Carn Wardrick. Capital of UK. Okay. Place names changed to protect the innocent. That is right, yeah? Carn Wardrick. I missed out an N. Carn Wardrick. Okay. Coda parks the van on a quiet street, gets out the saxophone he got out of nowhere. He blows a single note in silence in the distance. A smooth melody plays back in response. So I guess what can happen is, because he's wanted everywhere, they go into the jazz club, which is like a pub crossed with, it's like a jazz club. And no one knows. That's the Welsh spelling. That's what it is on Wikipedia. No one knows, are we going to meet the Coda's parents? Now I thought, it's not his parents, it's like, it'll be like his granddad, you know? And then who do we get to play the granddad? Charles Dance. Is that his name? I watched a film with him in yesterday. Have you seen Hope Gap? No, that's not Charles Dance. Wait, sorry, who's the guy in Hope Gap? What's this guy called again? Hope Gap. It's, what's his name? If you've seen it? I mean Bill Nighy. I mean Bill Nighy, not him. Bill Nighy is going to be the Coda's granddad. Billy Connolly. We don't. The thing is, they said we can't have too many Scottish people. He was great in Hot Fuzz. Oh, maybe not then. Has no one seen this film? Michael Caine. That's a very good shout, Silky Lemons. Master Libby. So. Back where it all began, where I was born. Carn Wardrick, capital of UK. Da-da-da. But why? Completely untraceable. The Flutter development came. Good luck, bro. The Flutter developer came. The Flutter developer. Thank you. I don't know what that is. Hello, the Flutter developer came. Good luck, bro. Well, thank you. Completely untraceable. So, what's Kane's Scottish accent like? Guys, we're not... There's no Scottish accents. We're going to Scotland, but we're not Irish. You know what I mean? Alert the Flutter development. I don't know if that's something I'm supposed to know about. Don't you know Flutter, WTF? Okay, so, completely untraceable. Back where it all began, where I was born. Carn Wardrick, capital of UK. But why? It's completely untraceable. No mobiles. No TVs. No TVs. Just code and jazz. American audience would say cell phone. Back where it's all been. Did he say no mobiles? Oh, good. You're right. Very good. Thank you very much. No cell phones, no TVs, just code and jazz. That's right. Only phones round here. Round here is the saxophone. Alright, that was Hot Reef's line. And what do we do in this? What do we do in this stream, everyone? What do we do when someone cometh with a great line for the old coder? That's right. They get the old VIP. So, I do really like this little album, this Stream Beats album. It's really good, isn't it? It was a two-team effort with VVS Safman. Okay, fine. But you did say something else before as well, which is really good, I think. Oh, God, I hate when this happens. People are like, no, VIP this one, VIP that one. Okay, so. Completely untraceable. No cell phones, no TVs. Just code and jazz. That's right. Only phones around here is the saxophone. Speaking of which, we can suddenly. They can. That's kind of more. They can suddenly hear saxophone music. At some point he can mention needing to go off grid, and while going off actual grid, I've never thought it through. I'll leave the nuances to the experts. Whilst going off an actual grid, right, silhouette of a guy holding a saxophone, yeah, like who's gonna play Bobby. Michael Sheen, 10:30. Let's have a think. It's Bobby the sax player, right? Jordan Alexander? I don't know who that is. Who's a big... Robbie Coltrane? That's not bad. Morgan Freeman. Ryan Reynolds. We could have an American. Try and get someone deeply uncool. I quite like that idea. Nelly. Val Kilmer. A hologram of James Gandolfini. Weird Al. Christian Bale's good. Del Toro. By the way, if you are wondering why there's not a lot of diversity in the cast, I said before, I want this to be a fully white cast, okay? And if you have a problem with that, then, you know, go watch Go watch Avocado Man 2. If you're going to be a woke brigade. Steven Seagal. But obviously the jazz player has to be a white guy, obviously. Kurt Russell, Pierce Brosnan. I like Pierce Brosnan. Excuse me. You would second Seagal? How does Steven Seagal speak? That's what we need to get in our mind. Steven Seagal interview. Daniel Day-Lewis? That's pretty good. I'm the average fool on the corner trying to... Brian, long time no see. Ladies and gentlemen, the coda, a real cool cat. And everyone in the jazz club clicks. And then Dingo's like, but don't they know... No, no, sir. Yeah, Dingo's like, don't they know you're a wanted man? And he can be like, no one watches the news. No one watches that round here. One foot in front of the other. Ewan McGregor? But the soft was the most severe. Ewan McGregor is good. And that was the riddle that most people didn't understand. So when you play in the sax, what most people don't understand. Stevens. Who's Stevens? Seagal would be good, but he has been accused of things by loads of women. Oh, okay. Thank you, Taki. Gary Oldman? Jack Black. How does Gary Oldman actually talk? Like, who could talk like, so who do we have who could be like, damn, you a cool cat, you know? Seagal would be perfect if he wasn't a bad fella. Sly Stallone. But we want him to be a jazz guy, but crucially has to be a white man. John Travolta? He could be like the wickedly talented. Ewan McGregor is slightly Scottish. How does he sound? Let's listen to a Ewan McGregor interview. But he doesn't sound Scottish at all, does he? Ewan McGregor interview, 1996. This you will need one television. This is for flipping Trainspotting.
Everybody's talking about your film. Now you are pretty cool in the film, but doesn't it worry you slightly just a little bit that if young kids see it, they may be tempted to get involved in acting?
yeah, it worries me a lot.
Yeah. What kind of criticisms have been levelled?
That was pretty good. That was a pretty good line.
The film that you've heard about. I mean, obviously, you expected all this.
Well, yeah, there's the whole kind of school of thought that the film will encourage people to do heroin.
There's a school of thought that the film will encourage people to do heroin. Brian, you're back. Wasn't expecting you.
But, it won't. So there you are.
But there you are. He's got an odd accent.
I don't know who's saying it. No friends of mine are saying that.
No friends of mine. He's got a weird... He doesn't sound...
Glorifies drugs? What are they saying?
Yeah, people say it glorifies drugs, but it doesn't really. I mean, it shows the pleasures of drugs up until a point in the movie, and then by the end of the movie...
A point in the movie. Yeah. So he's posh.
You're left in no doubt that...
Feather.
Heroin isn't a good idea. You know
Jeremy Paxman stuck up for you last night on Newsnight?
Yeah, good Jeremy.
Good Jeremy. You want posh and uncool. Maybe not Ewan. You think Ewan is slightly too cool? I don't know, he's in some crap. Pierce Brosnan is good. Hugh Grant. Christopher Walken. Who is Darius from Glasgow? Who's Darius? You don't mean he wasn't from Glasgow? Because I'm thinking of that singer, but it's not. Who's Darius? We all know it would be Ed Sheeran in the end. Liam Neeson. Gerard Butler. I don't think it should be a Scottish man. I think it should be... I think Michael Caine is good. Michael Caine interview. Richard E. Grant. Scotsman. Richard E. Grant plays the baddie in this. Ray Winston is good. Okay, let's listen to Michael Caine speak.
Home had sat there, and I said to my wife, I said, that's it. I just sat there, and I didn't watch television. I just said, I've done it. You know, I don't want to do anything else at the moment. Not for a week or so. The best.
I do too.
Yeah,
I think it's a marvelous performance. You play Fowler?
Hold me.
Let him speak.
And my food was cold by the time I finished.
Brian, you're back. If I know one thing, Brian, I know you're a real cool cat. Doesn't really sound like him. Ah, cheer my neck. Mark Rylance, or is he too big? I mean, I don't know who he is. Sir Ian McKellen. Ben Kingsley is good. This is Ian McKellen.
You spend a lot of your life doing Shakespeare.
Right,
and are successful at it. Certain parts occur to you.
I can't quite get these.
And most of the parts that I would like to have played, I have done. I've missed a few, but...
Alright, we're stuck on... Ross Kemp? Ben Kingsley and The Sopranos was a laugh. Yes. Louis Theroux. Okay, let's have a look. How does Ross Kemp sound? I think Ross Kemp is a good idea. The old man from Succession.
Is your wife relieved it's over?
Excuse me.
I think she quite likes to see the back of me for a bit. We've always believed in very quick goodbyes and very long hellos. And she met me. She's Australian. She's a lawyer. She was going back to Australia to take up a partnership. And for some unknown reason, she met me and she decided to stay. But she'd never seen EastEnders, so she was...
He is a bit Greg Wallace, so I was thinking
so she's
that.
As long as she's known me, I've been travelling around the world,
Okay, fine. He's just going to be a bland guy, okay? We're overthinking this. They can suddenly hear saxophone music. Coda parks the van... Parks this a mini bus. Do we call it a mini van, mini bus? What do we call it? What's saxophone? Saxophone, right. Coda's speeding around. The Coda parks the van outside the Carnwardrick Jazz Club. And they all go in. Okay. Now, how long is that? Is that a page or what? I just need to kind of try and keep track of. So that's not even a page. So basically halfway. Okay. So we did a bit more. How's it going, everyone? Is everyone okay and having a nice time? Steve Buscemi, Jude Law. Oh right, you're still trying to pick an actor. We can cast him in a minute, like. You know what? We shouldn't have got so hung up on trying to cast him. Jude Law. It's a fun Saturday night. That's great. Thank you, everyone. Cheers. Welcome. What I'll do is I wanted to write 2 pages by 10 o'clock and then have a quick, well, not a break, and then maybe play The Witcher 3 if people are into it. It's your first experience of the Coda. I think the read-through was pretty good today. I enjoyed that because I forgot. Genuinely fun and chill. Okay, that's nice. The Coda parks the van outside Carn Wodrick Jazz Club and they all go in. Interior. Is that right? I don't know. Have I spelled it wrong? I'm sorry if I have. Carn Wodrick Jazz Club. Evening. No, but don't worry about it. Excuse me. Oh, you enjoyed it last night, yeah? Okay, cool. Be nice to get back on The Witcher. Try and get... And in the meantime, try and get to my goal of 100 subs. How cool is the background, by the way? That's pretty good. Oh! Did I pause the music? Get that back on. What was that music I really liked? Was it this? Hold on. Isn't this... I find this really nice. Okay. I think the one you liked is The Lights in the Sky. Do you know it? Yeah, this is what I'm listening to now. Is this the one? Wait, there's one. Sorry, I have to find it. No, this. This one's called Vertigo. Listen to this bit when it gets going. Scotsman, thanks so much for gifting a sub to keep me posted, XX. This. Ah, it's really nice. So, there you go. You got some emotes now. Keep me posted. Carn Wodrick Jazz Club evening. Okay, so. It's really good, isn't it? It's a really good album, this one. Everyone, this is free to use Stream Beats. So there's no danger of getting demonetized on YouTube or getting your stream muted on playback if, you know, for the old DMCA nonsense. Not nonsense. If you're a streamer or whatever, just saying this is very good. Okay, I suppose. Thank you so much for your Prime sub. Welcome to the club. That's a really nice name as well. Okay underscore I underscore suppose. They enter the club. They enter the smoky. They enter the club. Smoke in the air. Smartly dressed. Audience members around round tables. You call that cabaret style seating in the industry, and it's actually not the preferred thing. You usually have cabaret style seating, dim candlelight. Yeah, usually have cabaret style seating if you've not sold that many tickets. So smartly dressed, but in this club, it's like there's not many people in the town, right? Audience members around. Around round tables, it's fine. Around round tables, dimly lit. Waiters dance around them. We have a famous jazz man we can bring in. Wait, who? What, Craig Russell Horne? So, Please just have the sax solo from Baker Street. I've already been cast in this film. I played the newsreader. I meant that as a way of describing their movements. Sorry, lol. Oh, right. I thought you meant actually dancing around them, but you meant they dance. Yeah. I suppose that could be confusing in a script like this. Sorry, it's a bit loud for me. The music level's okay, yeah? They enter the club, smoke in the air, smartly dressed audience members around round tables, dimly lit. Okay? So. They'll recognize you, Brian. They'll recognize you. Oh, you're gonna tell me to spell it with a Z? Fine. They'll recognize you. Am I on the right screen, yeah? Yeah, got your chat on the side there. They'll recognize you. Coda says. No one here watches the news. And even if they did, they know grassing is the eighth, shall we say the eighth deadly sin? Wait. Something like that. The eighth deadly sin. Is the eighth deadly sin. And then crucially what happens is that paperclip gulps, right? Paperclip gulps in fear because he's gonna be a grass in it at some point. It's okay, I'm encrypted. Grasses get slashes. Grassing is all seven deadly. They know how to keep it zipped. Yep, that's good. So, paperclip gulps in fear. Okay, so. I think someone's got to die. Maybe not today, but Paperclip's going to get killed, basically. Dingo might get killed at the end, just so you know. Should he call him a wee clip? Because Scotland. Paperclip kills Bobby. Something like that. Do we have a page? I love this song as well. This is so nice. We've written about Page. Paper got clipped. This is like me doing an essay. Write 5 words, check the word count. You're right, Hot Reef. But the reason I'm doing it is because in scripts, basically, so if any of you don't know, a page is roughly a minute. So adding 3 little bits might be the end of a page, you know? So I'm trying to, because I wanted to, we try and write 2 minutes each time. I think next week we're going to do way more. If we do it next week. Double space, 1.5 paragraph gap. That's class. Death by USB stick. So we've done something like that already, where he used a USB stick, he chucked it on some oil and it lit up because he removed it unsafely from a laptop. You know. Paperclip gulps in fear. The sax man on stage goes into a the sax man on stage goes into a powerful solo, right? So he's like, with the amount of stage direction the boss puts in each page is actually 15 seconds. That's not how it works, podcast merch, you cheeky boy. That is not how it works in scripts. Stage direction takes up time. This little bit here, them entering the club and looking around, that's a long little bit. You've got to see it, you've got to see everything, you know. We could just establish that they are moved back to Samantha. So, dear Dr. Samedi84, shall we have the coda do some scat singing? Who can we watch do it? Who's a real one? Louis Armstrong's. Listen to this.
Oh,
when the saints
go marching in,
oh, marching in.
When the saints go marching in,
oh, yeah.
I wanna be,
oh,
in that number.
And the great bomb
and Chopin,
solid man. And Bach, that great old master,
yeah, that great old master was a gasser.
Yes, but Mozart the most with all he had.
With the symphonies and operas and all that jazz.
Oh, God. Sesame Street, Hoot the Owls teaches scat singing. Oh my god. Joey Blake and Bobby McFerrin, vocal improvisation. So,
that
this
will
might
happen
be
when you come to one of these bombing.
Well, I'm gonna stop for something.
It's actually quite nice.
Joey being me for a long time,
long time,
long time.
No, this is just good.
Long time.
This is just nice.
Make me step out of the safe place.
Okay, podcast merch, you're right. What should happen is, okay, and then what happens is, except, the coda begins to, how would you say it, begins to do the exact scat verse from, what's the song called? From I'm a Scat Man. So he starts doing this. Is it called Scat Man or I'm a Scat Man? So he does this bit. So he does this first bit.
I'm a Scat Man.
The coda becomes the no, okay, so the coda does the coda suddenly does the intro from the song Scatman, right? The bar goes completely silent. But but then the sax player joins in as the coda. So what it is, it's like this, as the coda does the chorus, right? So then what happens is then you've got coda going beep ba 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 da bo ba da ba da ba be. Okay, so then they're doing it together, right? Ba da ba da ba. He has to sing "I'm the Code Man." No, I think that's too far. Let's put it in anyway. I'm the code. I'm the code man. Okay. Thank you, Scotsman. He's not the Mac Man talkie because this is all PCs. That's very good. And then dot dot dot. He's the sax man. The coda points at the sax player. Everyone in the jazz club is dancing. Even Dingo nods his head. Subtitles to the song appear on movie screen with ball puffing along. Oh, Bing instead of bar. Get the cat in the background vibe along. Paperclip could look confused. Is there a version of Saxman with Scatman with saxophone, I wonder? Of course there is. Oh no. No, she's called Ellie Sax. Oh, it is! So here goes. This isn't it. Is it? So that's it. So here goes. Hey, pa 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 da pa. Pa 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 da pa. Hey, so he's doing that. He's a sax man. And there's a beat, even in the film, a beat kicks in, but it's like there's no one else on the stage. Everyone sings it like a football chant. Everyone in the club joins in with the singing. Okay. Whole song and encore. That's another Seven Mansfield. Everyone in the club joins in with the singing. This is beautiful, boss. Should a rapper come out of nowhere? It could be Plan B. Like, let me tell you about the code, man. You need Paperclip looking shifty at this point. That's good. That's actually very good. Paperclip looks, just say shifty. Shifty and a bit scared, okay? Plan B is also an actor, exactly. I think Clippy isn't evil. He's just weak and has betrayed them. I agree, Tarky. That's exactly what I was thinking. He's not evil. He's like a loser. And, yeah, he's given them up. That's why any talk around grassing gets him a bit. Like, he doesn't get it. An outsider sacks his band at Omicron or whatever. there haven't been any helicopters, but I think there will be. I'm the code man. He's the sax man. The code points to the sax player. Everyone in the jazz club is dancing. 57, even Dingo nods his head. Everyone in the club joins in with the singing. So bad. Paperclip looks shifty and a bit scared. They do a choreographed dance. Exactly, exactly. You got it. Should have Richard E. Grant trying to phone Clippy. I wonder if we don't even reveal that yet, because I like that what can happen is... Ah, I've got it. As Clippy... So as the coder does the special code to reach Samantha, Clippy does it to reach Omniflux. And they both find out when they're on their date. So they don't know that each other knows about this. Do you know what I mean? Maybe. Something like that. Let me read this scene from the beginning. Well, let's see what we have so far. Okay. Coda is speeding around the countryside with Dingo and Paperclip. There's absolutely no signal. Where the hell are we?
Home.
You what, bruv?
Back where it all began. Where I was born. Carnwardrick. Capital of UK.
But why?
Completely untraceable. No cell phones, no TVs. Just code and jazz. That's right. Only phones around here is a saxophone. Speaking of which...
They can suddenly hear saxophone music. The coder parks the van outside the Carnwardrick Jazz Club and they all go in. Interior Carnwardrick Jazz Club evening. They enter the club, smoke in the air... Smartly dressed audience members around the around round tables, dimly lit.
They'll recognise you. No one here watches the news, and even if they did, they know grassing is the eighth deadly sin.
Paperclip gulps in fear. The sax man on stage goes into a powerful solo. The coda suddenly does the intro from the song Scatman. The bar goes completely silent, but then the sax player joins in as the coda does the chorus.
Be-ba-ba-ba-da-bo. Ba-ba-ba. I'm the code man. He's the sax man.
The coder points at the sax player. Everyone in the jazz club is dancing. Even Dingo nods his head. Everyone in the club joins in with the singing. Paperclip looks shifty and a bit scared. Okay? It's pretty good so far. It's actually decent, right? Now... Could have the bar going quiet, record skip, and he starts scatting. When they enter the club, they should be all be wearing smart clothes from out of nowhere. Can Dingo ask the coder why he feels he has to dance? Could the scart man as the link with the computers? I think that's, I don't know, I feel like that's too much. Black trilby with white lines. I just joined, what is happening? Oh dear. So, this is what he does, right, in the...
I'm the code man.
Everyone's dancing in the place, right?
He's a sax man. Code man.
Jesus. I mean, it's a good cover. Like, it's a catchy song at the end, you know, to be fair. Paperclip looks shifty and a bit scared, okay? I ordered an Uber Eats at the start of the first lockdown. It was supposed to be a contract-free delivery. The fella kept ringing the doorbell and answered it. He was in full black suit and white tie and a trilby. Yeah, that's a problem. That's a good chance for a musical montage. Do they still have their three-piece suits on from earlier? You know what would actually happen in the film? As that bit's going on, the music, it would cut to Samantha Kennedy going to Omniflux offices and like looking around a bit in the reception. And then whoever, who's playing the sax man? If it's Ross Kemp, it's like, Brian, still alive. Now, how does he talk? Still alive, you son of a gun. Or whatever. I can see you're still a pretty cool cat yourself. No, the sax player is based on a real guy called Bobby. Sorry, if you're just arriving. Carl Mordrick. That sounds like how he says it, which is where the coder is from. We checked the Wikipedia, and the only two people, notable people, are... This is why there's a jazz club. It's because the only two notable people from that area are the coder and Bobby, a late jazz player. A late saxophone player. That's why this has happened. Because we have to say at the start, based on a true story. I thought you were talking about Bobby the cat. No. But what a coincidence. As if that's a coincidence, by the way. Paperclip looks shifty and a bit scared. It's not a coincidence. Bobby goes, ladies and gentlemen, Brian, Coda, Limmy. I think maybe that's the first time. Maybe it'd be good to actually have... That's what he's known as in his hometown, you know. I've subsequently realised why someone suggested 10:30 should play Bobby in a cat suit. Right. Honestly, you lot don't listen sometimes. Unless you just arrived when I was casting Bobby. Keep hearing Iggy Pop's voice as Bobby now. So if it's Iggy Pop playing him. Thanks for the boost of the stream, everyone. I have no idea what that means. Ladies and gentlemen, Brian, the coder, Limmy. There's a big round of applause in the club. Okay, now, he'd be shirtless if it's Iggy. Yeah. So, they enter the club, smoke in the air, smartly dressed, dimly lit, paperclip got some fear, the sax man on stage, long blonde hair, topless, goes into a powerful solo. The coda suddenly does the intro from the song Scatman. The bar goes completely silent, but the sax player joins in as the coda does the chorus. And so what I can do is I can play that bit. The coda points at the sax player. Everyone in the jazz club is dancing. Even Dingo nods his head. Everyone in the club joins in with the singing. Paperclip looks shifty and a bit scared. Ladies and gentlemen, Brian, the coda, Limmy. There's a big round of applause in the club. Okay? He calls him by his real name. Everyone looks around because Dingo only knows him as the coder. Exactly. Exactly. Dingo looks at Coda in shock. I thought he could have been like, so you're Scatman Limmy, but I mean, I don't know if that's too much. As if there is too much. Haim67, thank you so much for subscribing. Welcome to the club. Thank you very much. Don't forget to save. That's a good point. Yeah, I would have actually forgotten. There you go, I've saved it. Limmy from Limmy Travel. Do a Prime ad, you're right. Guys, did you know if you have Amazon Prime, not only can you watch some stuff. Ooh. Not only can you watch some fantastic content, free content, films, TV shows, all of that, but if you have Amazon Prime, you also have a free subscription to any streamer you want. Now, of course, you can use that on any stream. Look, there's loads of good streamers, or you can give it to the best in the streaming industry. I'm speaking, of course, about Pokimane. Jeff Bezos hates me. Jeff. Dingo looks at the coder in shock. There's a big round of applause in the club. Okay. So, shall we leave it there for the script today? What I can do is when I read it out for the old clipping, we can have it. So it's from there. So I'll actually play that. So what we do now at this stage of it is, everyone, can I firstly say, wait, where are we up to? We're at the end of page 19. Did we? We've done more than a page. Okay, we've done a couple of pages today, actually. So we're on, when we come back, we'll be on page 20. Yes, why is this so good? It's a good song. Like, I mean, you know, it's catchy. We could type out the lyrics to pad it a bit more. Don't worry about the padding. The thing is, I think we should aim for 60 pages, really, not 90. I'm pleased the coda hath returned. Thank you. So, I think we'll leave the writing there, everyone. And now what we'll do is, I've got to press record here, and I'm going to use this clip. Okay. So this is the next. Where does it start? The next page. It starts from the minivan. I think this is pretty good. Okay, so everyone, well done. Thank you very much for helping me write this. It's a fun collaborative experience. Very much so. I really do love doing this. I am now going to read what we've written so far today. It does kind of write itself. You're right. I mean, it's but yeah, we have some great suggestions here. Look at that list of VIPs. Makes you sick. So, without any more further ado, let's read through what we have today. Interior, minivan, evening. Coda is speeding around the countryside with Dingo and Paperclip. There's absolutely no signal. Where the hell are we? Home. You what, bruv? Back where it all began. Where I was born. Carl Waldrick. Capital of UK. But why? Completely untraceable. No cell phones, no TVs. Just code and jazz. That's right. Only phones round here is the saxophone. Speaking of which, they can suddenly hear saxophone music. The coda parks the van outside the Carnwardrick Jazz Club and they all go in. Interior, Carnwardrick Jazz Club evening. They enter the club, smoke in the air, smartly dressed audience members around tables, dimly lit. They'll recognise you. No one here watches the news, and even if they did, they know grassing is the eighth deadly sin. Paperclip gulps in fear. The sax man on stage, long blonde hair, topless, goes into a powerful solo. The coda suddenly does the intro from the song Scatman. The bar goes completely silent, but then the sax player joins in as the coda does the chorus. I'm the code man. He's the sax man. The coda points at the sax player. Everyone in the jazz club is dancing. Even Dingo nods his head. Everyone in the club joins in with the singing. Paperclip looks shifty and is a bit scared. Ladies and gentlemen, Brian the Coder Limmy. There's a big round of applause in the club. Dingo looks at Coda in shock.
I'm Code Man. He's a sax man.
Lovely stuff, everyone. Lovely, lovely stuff. Don't forget to get the rights. Hot Reef, don't worry about that. If we have to change it slightly, that's fine. That was great, I think. That was great. Now, I know it wasn't action-packed today, but next week, what's going to happen is... Well done, everyone. Good work. What's going to happen next week is we're going to go into... Samantha's going to go on a date with the baddie, okay? Absolutely savage, not going to lie. Now, I have to switch scene now, as in switch scenes within OBS. So what we have here is all the scenes just for Coda, and then I've got the other one for gaming, obviously Pez and stuff, right? So I'm going to switch over to that. Now, the stream's probably going to cut out. Just so you know, because I could end it and come back on, but it might cut out. Okay. Right. So you'll probably get a little. There'll probably be something. It will seem like an F, but I'm switching over. So, BRB 2 seconds. Did that work fine? Was that smooth? That was cool. I thought that was going to like take ages. What can I get to drink? Because I can't have a coffee at this time. I'm going to get a hot drink, everyone. Hold on. Oh, I could have some soup. I could make myself some soup and... That's what I'll do, because I've had sort of my big meal. Bingo. Hot cocoa with marshmallows. I'm off the junk. All right, everyone, so I'll be right back in like literally a few minutes, and then shall we play The Witcher? We'll